So for some of you that has been visiting Indonesia, yeah, you must saw yeah, rivers in Indonesia is choked with plastic. This is the situation in Brantas River. So this condition can be seen in the densely populated area like Surabaya, Malang, Gresik, and Sidoarjo. Yeah. So as river ecologists, we work to protect our rivers in Indonesia in healthy condition to defend drinkable, fishable, and swimmable waters. It's very frustrating to see how plastic is destroying our environment, our ecosystem. But we can't do much to prevent plastic crisis when there is lack of policy to prevent plastic pollution, lack of budget allocated to improve waste management system, and lack of infrastructure to handle the waste properly. Plastic pollution is visible everywhere, but still it's being ignored by most of the plastic producers, government, and the plastic consumers. Who is really responsible for this plastic pollution? We know that plastic is made from fossil fuel and toxic additive, so this plastic crisis should not be treated as waste management problems, because the plastic itself is the problem. Plastic fuels climate crisis. It releases persistent organic pollutants, endocrine disrupting chemicals. It's contaminating our food chain and poisoning our health. So in every stage of its life cycle, plastic is associated with hazardous waste chemical. We will not stop plastic crisis if the tap of plastic flow is keep running at full speed. If we are aware that we are in a crisis, first thing to do is to turn off the tap of plastic production. Flexible plastic packaging contributed to 17% of plastic trash that polluting environment in Indonesia. So every year Indonesia generates 68 million tons of plastic of waste, and 14% leak into environment. 47% is handled by open burning. We know that burning plastic is common way to deal with the plastic waste, where people don't have access to waste collection system and treatment facilities. So ECOTON and IPEN do research of POPs in four locations of massive burning site in East Java. We found high concentration of brominated flame retardant, dioxin, PCB, PBDE in egg samples of free-range chicken. The level of dioxin contamination at tofu factories that use plastic as fuel is very high. So it reached the level of dioxin at Binh Hoa in Vietnam that used to be an army base of US during Vietnamese war. To fight plastic crisis, we have to follow waste management hierarchy, where protection, prevention should be the most preferred and the top priority. We need more policy to ban single-use plastic. And multi-layer sachet packaging, we should ban in the developing country that don't have facility to treat their waste. So we develop model of zero waste city to support circular economy by enforcing waste segregation at source to optimize recyclables collection and organic waste composting to reduce waste goes to landfill. So the petrochemical industry and fast-moving consumer goods company should be held accountable at every stage of plastic life cycle from production to disposal. Plastic crisis is our legacy to next generation. The children and youth now are fighting for their right for clean and healthy environment, for the climate justice. As parents, we must join the movement to fight plastic pollution for the sake of our children. So let's stop plastic pollution, starting from our home with three R's: reduce, reduce, reduce single-use plastic.
Yes, Madam.
Okay, thank you, Daru. I stand here because I love my river. I fall in love my river because this river is very important for me. Because we have this river, Surabaya River, is an important drinking water source for more than 6 million people in six city. And but today my river is full with the plastic. So this is plastic, yeah. So 42% floating waste in the river is plastic, and 37% is diapers. And when the river is polluted by microplastic, it will accumulate in the food chain, and that will harm our human health. As a father, I have three daughters, and I worry with my daughter because they drinking from this river. So I must do something for my family. So I want everyone to know about the dangers of the microplastic. So we push all people to reduce using single-use plastic and stop dumping trash into the river. But I realize it is difficult to make people aware on the stop using plastic. How can they see microplastic as a problem when the larger plastic pollution cannot be seen? So every year Indonesia produces more than 8 million plastic waste. Only 3 million we can manage. 5 million we cannot manage. 2.6 million we dumping to the river. So why Indonesia is second largest polluter plastic waste to the ocean? So in the tropical country, the plastic is faster breaking into microplastic. Then I try to connect the microplastic impact to the human. So I want to show this is plastic, this is problem. So I did the plastic cleanup in the sea, in the mangrove, in the river. So it's failed, and so many people don't support our campaign. So I start another activity. So I become an evacuator. So I evacuate all diapers in the river in the Java island. Every 2 weeks, we using our car to looking for the bridges because all people dumping waste, especially diapers in the bridge. So it was failed too because people still dropping the waste into the river. So then I do some research because I'm a biology. I do research of in our food. So we identify the sex behavior of the fish. We found that 80% in our river, the fish is a female, and 20% is male. Normally, it's 50-50. It's because EDC. It's because so many microplastic and so many they absorb the pollution, and it's make a problem with our fish. So it's our river. There is so many paper pulp company using import waste. They import waste from the developed country and then recycling and then dumping the waste to the river. And so we found a lot of microplastic in this river. So we do a lot of research to identify the microplastic in the effluent, in the water, in the fish, in the salt sea, in the sediment, in the shellfish. All sample is contamination with microplastic. But still, people don't care about the situation. So yeah, but if we so we finally do something nasty, we ask people to donate their poop, their faeces. So in 1 year, we collect 102 poop.
Sample.
10 gram sample, yeah. So with my friend Andreas and with Gede Robi, is vocalist of a band in Indonesia, we collect more than 100 sample, and this, I think this is the dirtiest job that ever I've done. Yeah. It was quite difficult to collect poo sample and assure people that we would analyze their faeces, use them for a scientific purpose. Yes, we often rejected because they think we will use it to practice the black magic. Yeah. So difficult, so why we need 1 year? Yeah. So after that, we identify, we found 38 type of polymer. Polypropylene, low density, LDPE, PET, and PS. We found 38 type of polymer, and we found 50 particle microplastic in each, in 10 gram of faeces. Yeah. Yeah, and then we must try something. We must tell story about this to our children. So why we establish this one UU? This is we promote to encourage youth awareness in microplastic issue. We are planning to develop UU in floating river and plastic education center to make youth closely connect with river and learn about the microplastic in here. So we promote with the river detective program to involve hundreds of children to examine microplastic is more abundant than plankton. So with this, we're using this small tool, this easier, and we can deliver to all of river Indonesia with the milk can and the net and the strip. So we can using this to identify the microplastic in the water with the 10 liters of water. So in the picture, we saw that 100 of students along the river is learning about so many microplastic than plankton in our river. And then we call a lot of women group to train them to understand about the real situation of our river. And then it's me. Before I go here, I take a picture with my family. This is a family of microplastic. Hanging up is a fragment, foam, is a fiber, and in the down is the plankton family. You can count, it's 6 versus 4. So many microplastic in my river than a plankton. So today I will introduce my family, microplastic family. So I hope we need to collaborate for sharing knowledge about health impact of microplastic, to change people's habit to stop using single-use plastic, especially in the developing country. Please stop using single-use plastic, and please don't eat plastic. Thank you.